The truth is that every penny of your tax dollars pays for your nation's national debt to the banksters. The banksters then loan your hard-earned tax money back to your government and charge interest on it for your basic public services. Before the bombing and theft of the country of Iraq, every citizen in America owed the banksters $70,000 per citizen. It is your skyrocketing debt and your nation's skyrocketing debt to the banksters that have helped them enslave the world, and they're doing it with your money, your labor, and your approval. Since the ruling families and their brotherhood of wealthy insiders hide their wealth and don't pay taxes, why should you? Find ways to avoid paying tax monies to these gangsters. If you earn an average salary over your lifetime, you will pay the banksters more than $1 million in taxes. 3/4 of your lifetime of work pays for your government's debt to the banksters and your personal debt to the banksters on your mortgaged house, your car loan, student loans, and other loans. The banksters' game is all about taking your money in taxes and then loaning your money back to you again with interest. They take property taxes, gas taxes, food taxes, clothing taxes, and dozens of other taxes and fees. Collectively, the public willingly hands over trillions of dollars annually to the banksters by depositing money in their banks, paying taxes to their central banks, supplying labor to their corporations, buying stock in their corporations, and then spending savings in their corporate superstores. So what do the banksters do with all your money that they pocket? They bomb, rob, kill, colonize, exploit, and advance their cause for global control and for your eventual enslavement. A third solution is to refuse to fight the banksters' murderous wars and to stop supporting others who fight their wars. One of America's favorite slogans is, support your troops, which means support your troops no matter what. Even if the war is a lie. Even if innocent families are being bombed, burned, and crippled with your tax money. Even if your tax money is paying teenagers in uniform to die by the thousands for the lie. The majority of recruited soldiers are naive, duped, unemployed teenagers who are romanced into believing they are heroes fighting for freedom. But what they are fighting for is the wealthy ruling families who are systematically disarming the world of all weapons of resistance to their global empire.
Not to conquer anybody, but to liberate people.
A fourth solution is to stop voting. Most nations have two main political parties, which means there are only two candidates for the top job. One is the candidate for the very rich, and the other is the candidate for the even richer. Both candidates are sponsored by the lobby groups of the ruling families. Many voters feel a need to vote for the lesser of two evils. But they are still voting for evil and supporting a corrupt electoral system. Both John Kerry and George Bush are members of Yale University's Skull and Bones Secret Brotherhood, which is rooted in German Freemasonry. Not only are Bush and Kerry Skull and Bonesmen, they are also descendants of British royalty, the black nobility, and the Hebrew tribes of Israel. A fifth solution is to stop obeying laws designed to disempower you. The success of the ruling families depends on your obedience of their laws that they make and break, including the Ten Commandments. A sixth solution is to buy small and think big. Stop shopping at corporate superstores like Walmart or corporate grocery chains which are owned by the ruling families and their affiliates. Buy from small businesses and farmers' markets. Grow your own natural food. The banksters have been genetically modifying and patenting the food you eat, the seeds you need for growing food, as well as animal DNA. Corporate farming that supplies meat to corporate grocery stores subjects animals to painful, inhumane crowding, filth, cruelty, and abuse. A seventh solution is to stop donating to charities. Most of it pays administration fees. The ruling families have set up big charities and foundations to create a friendly, charitable image of themselves and to cover up their real agenda. Big charities serve as a hiding place to launder dirty money from the drugs and weapons trade. The Queen's husband, Prince Philip, is the international president of the World Wildlife Fund, which is one of the worst offenders. An eighth solution is to stop identifying with a flag or a national anthem. Refuse to sing praises to America's bombs bursting in air, or to Britain's gracious and noble queen, who is neither gracious or noble. A ninth solution is to refuse to recognize the illegitimate claims of the ruling families to your nation's water, land, resources, railways, airlines, power companies, health plans, and other publicly held properties that they have been busy privatizing while you were sleeping. The ruling families have been stealing your nation's land and resources through corporate privatization, which means they've been buying up your nation's publicly owned property. And where is it all leading? To an eternal world empire in which the power of these ruling families can never be challenged, and the earth and all living things will be helplessly at their mercy. A tenth solution is to name names. Focus the blame where it belongs, on the ruling families, not on their faceless corporations. Corporations like WorldCom, Enron, Merrill Lynch, and Halliburton are owned by real people with real names and real faces. The general public is deceived into believing that ordinary people who invest and buy shares in these giant corporations actually own them. Nothing could be further from the truth. The only shares that really matter are the Class A shares, all of which are owned by the ruling families. Their hand-picked lackeys who sit in for them as company directors get shuffled around like packs of slippery cards. The 11th solution is to reject the propaganda that keeps you passive. Bible believers are taught that an apocalypse and the reign of a satanic world ruler are inevitable because the Bible says so. Don't protest, don't resist, be passive. These messages are repeated over and over again to millions of Bible believers worldwide. Since the ruling families view religion as the opiate of the masses, they provide funding for organized religion worldwide. Christians, Muslims, and Jews have been tricked into praising their god Amun at the end of every prayer. A 12th solution is to arrest the Committee of 300 ruling families for their